Hello everyone, our topic of the paper is MDCT in evaluation of mediastinal teratomas. I'm Dr. Vivek, postgraduate resident in Department of Diagnosis at Delhi Bachman Institute of Medical Science and Dr. Harman Hospital, under the guidance of Dr. Kavita Vani, Associate Professor and Head, Department of Radiodiagnosis. Germ cells tumors include teratomas, they may arise de novo or from tuberous cell cells of thymus. Teratoma germ cell tumors which contain derivatives of all germ layers, they are classified as mature, cystic, mature, and malignant ones. Mediastinal germ cell tumors are usually detected incidentally in routine chest graphs, or the patient will be symptomatic if the tumor is large sized, compresses adjacent structures, and invades adjacent structures. The very CT findings say they have been deficient in benign versus malignant lesions. Like benign lesions are usually well defined, they are cystic and major of the lesions contain flat. While malignant lesions are nodular, poorly defined, ill defined, they are more likely to have a solid enhancing mass, lesion mass within the teratoma, along with a very small portion of the tumor containing fat. Malignant teratomas, they have a greater tendency to compress or invade adjacent structures. Mediastinum is an uncommon site for teratoma, and it's rare to find teratoma in posterior mediastinum. So, aim of the paper is to identify mediastinal teratomas and characterize them based on location, imaging features, and invasion. This study was carried out in Department of Radiodiagnosis at Dr. Harman Hospital in a total of 30 patients. We started with a chest X-ray of screening modality for all those patients who were having suspected of mediastinal pathology. Subsequently, CCD chest was done. And the CCD was done in a 128-slice Siemens monitor CT scanner. The patients who were clinically suspected of mediastinal mass or incident detected on chest X-rays, they were included in the study, while those patients who were having severe allergy to contrast or pain in femurs, they were excluded from the study. Starting the cases, this is the first case of 50-year-old male with complaints of chest pain for last 3 months. Came to our hospital, patient underwent x-rays. This is a chest x-ray POV. We can see there is a large mass which is ablated out outline, which is surrounded by lung on one side. We can see there is a hyaluronic acid is clearly seen passing through the mass, along with the cardiac silhouettes are clear, not obscured by the mass. So on the basis of x-ray, this gives an impression of posterior mediastinal mass. This is a CCT, axial, and the sagittal images. We can see there is a large mass which is involving both sides of the posterior mediastinum, along with the areas of pores, calcification, and fat retention areas within the mass is displacing the cardiomyocytal structures anteriorly. The mass then will also fit with both the main bronchuses along with the aorta. We can see the mass is displacing the cardiomyocytal structures anteriorly. The mass is going splaying of carina along with loss of fat in both the bronchuses along with the displacement of the cardiomyocytal structures anteriorly and laterally. We can also see a lytic area in a T7 vertebral body anteriorly, which is a metastatic lesion. So this is a case of an immature teratoma with malignant changes. Coming to second case, this is a 30-year-old male with complaints of heaviness in chest for last 3 months. Chest X-ray showed a soft tissue density lesion in mediastinum. Subsequently, CCD chest was done. We can see there is a well-defined cystic mass with a thick peripheral enhancement along with the internal hyperdense areas within, which is having loss of fat from adjacent mediastinal pleura. However, fat filled with the aorta are maintained. The mass is small in size, well-defined internal cystic area, and the small size not having mass effect and adjacent structures not involving invading adjacent structures. So this is a case of mature teratoma. This is a case 3 of 25-year-old male with complaints of chest pain for last 1.5 months. Chest X-ray showed suspicious mass in calcified popliteal mediastinal region. So this is only CCD chest was done. We are provided with the axial and caudal and sagittal images of the CCD chest. You can see the mass is minimal enhancing. This is a large mass which is involving anterior medial mediastinum, the obliterated outline, minimal enhancing, having calcific foci and hypertense areas within, which is encasing the subclavian arteries, having loss of fat in the aorta, along with the mediastinum, loss of fat in the mediastinum, and having mass effect on adjacent cardiovascular structures, displacing the degraded vessels and the heart. So, this is a case of immature teratoma. This is a case for a 32-year-old male with complaints of chest pain, dyspnea for last 5 months. Chest X-ray showed a large mass in mediastinum, which is displacing adjacent mediastinal structures. These are the CCT, axial, and coronal images. We can see that there is a large mass in the anterior medial mediastinum, which is displacing the heart inferiorly, along with the displacing adjacent mediastinal structures and invading and having loss of fat retained with the aorta, having encasing the superior vena cava, along with a large effusion on the right side. There is a small effusion on the right, left side, but there is a large effusion on the right side, along with thickening of the pleura. And the mass is having loss of fat retained with the pulmonary artery, with the aorta, displacing the mediastinal structure posteriorly. We can see both the loss of fat retained with both the bronchus, along with displacement of the structures posteriorly. So, this is a case of immature teratoma with malignant degeneration, which has gradually progressed over time. We can see that the mass is having a large mass is having there is a pleural thickening along with the malignant likely chances of malignant effusion. So this is a case of major teratoma with malignant degeneration along with suspicious pleural metastasis. So in total of 30 patients who underwent the study, 15 were having anterior mediastinal masses, 12 were medial mediastinal masses, and 3 were proximal mediastinal masses. Out of the anterior mediastinal masses, 10 were having mature mass, while 5 were having mature teratomas. Out of medial mediastinal masses, 7 were having mature teratoma, 4 cases of mature teratoma, and 1 teratoma with malignant degeneration. Posterior mediastinal masses include 2 cases of mature teratoma and 1 case of mature teratoma. Few of the lesions were seen involving more than one compartment. However, they were classified on the basis of the main compartment in which they were epicentered. So, coming to discussion, mature teratomas are most common. They're benign, composed of well-defined tissues, the ectodermal elements such as skin and hairs. They also contain fat, muscles, cartilage. This is most commonly seen in children and young adults. Dermoids, they're also known as mature fissure teratomas. They can contain many elements of ectodermal layers of germ cells, like skin and its appendages. However, extraparal zone to a zone as elements of endodermal and mesodermal cells within. The major treatment are poorly defined, contain cells and tissues of fetal development. They are mainly seen in potential children, they follow benign course. However, if they are seen in adults, they follow aggressive and malignant course. Malignant teratomas contain frail malignant tissue in addition to mature and immature tissues. They vary prognostically. They are seen exclusively in main and usually adenocarcinomas, even mature teratomas, angiosarcomas, or adenocarcinomas, mature teratomas. Teratomas are uncommon to find in mediastinum. Even if they are seen in mediastinum, they are mainly seen in anterior mediastinum. It's rare to find posterior mediastinal teratomas, but one case of posterior mediastinal teratoma has been attached in this paper. The role of X-ray, the X-ray has to compartmentalize that mass into intermediate posterior compartment based on the lateral and PA views and on the basis of hilum overall signs, cervical thoracic signs, thoracic sign, and they may also be either calcification or fat extensions within the mask. MDCT is the primary modality which has a differentiate between benign and malignant lesions. Benign lesions are well-defined, smooth, cystic, non-majority of the recurrent fats. While malignant lesions, they are nodular, poorly defined. They have large solid enhancing mark component with a very small area containing fat. They have tendency, malignant lesions have tendency to infiltrate on compressed adhesion structures. So we concluded that MDCT is a modality of choice to confirm a diagnosis, differentiate between benign and malignant masses and describe extent and state of invasion for better pre-op and post-op outcome. Chest radiograph helps to narrow our differentials. Thank you.